John, you've got to help Cherokee. She'll never pull through without you.
I stopped being a doctor 10 years ago. You know that.
I guess we all stopped being something or other after we came out here. Except maybe flesh and blood.
My dear Duchess,
I thought you and I understood our partnership.
We're out here to help each other.
But at least we've got enough humanity left to help one of our own girls.
We're out here to help ourselves.
Each according to his own private taste. Some do it with picks and shovels, and we dig too.
Rather lean pockets these days.
There's no time to think of that now.
Pretty well dug out around here. There'll be new claims and richer diggings. We'll soon be on our way again.
Oh, plans can wait, but not Cherokee's baby. Babies get born when they've got to get born. And you're the only one to handle this case.
Excuse me, Mr. Oakhurst. There's an argument at the second table. The boys claim your dealer's a little partial to the house.
That baby will have to wait, Duchess. Those miners won't.
You ain't gonna do it no more.
Complaints here?
Funny. What kind of place you running here?
This is a palace of amusement.
Yeah, crooked as a ram's horn. What you...
I'll handle this. I don't think my temper's as short as yours. Now, just what is your grievance?
Your man here palmed a king on us. We all saw him.
Yes, sir, we did.
That's a pretty serious charge, Mr. Dealer. How about it?
Why, they're lying, Mr. Oakhurst.
I prefer to believe my customers. Get out. Now, let's have your claims.
I won this pot.
Take it. With my apologies. Won't happen again.
Thanks, Mr. Oakhurst.
Back to your games, everybody. Everything is peaceful. Play some music, Professor.
Do you wish to continue?
Yes, sir. Sure, no.
Cherokee's awful sick. She needs you bad, Mr. Oakhurst.
Yeah, and besides, it ain't respectable for a gal to become a mother without a doctor. And it ain't good hospitality, neither.
If I've got to do it, I want some assistance from Stumpy Carter. He's had a lot more recent experience than I've had. Where is Stumpy?
There he is.
Stumpy, wake up. Cherokee needs you.
Oh, I can't do a thing with him. He's dead drunk.
Kentuck, the persuader.
Give it to me.
What happened?
What's the meaning of this? What's going on here?
It's Cherokee Sal's baby. You've got to help us.
Well, now. At your service, ladies. Always at your service.
Come on. Gentlemen, I'm betting it's a female.
If it is, you can have it.
I'll take 100 of that even money. Same here.
Me too.
Kentuck, record those bets.
What do we call it?
Trouble.
He's a boy, I swear.
Welcome to Poker Flat.
Bless it.
Well, what is it?
It's a girl.
And no bigger than a derringer.
I win. Kentuck, don't forget to collect those bets.
Yes, sir.
What's it weigh?
About 6 pounds.
Pay me.
Sure will.
What color hair?
Bald.
Bald?
Bald. Quick drink.
Cherokee. Dead. Gee.
Well, it's gone, baby. This was right smart.
Well, what are we going to do with the kid? Anybody want it? Don't all speak at once.
We could get a nurse up from Red Banks.
Nobody'd leave a town like Red Banks to come here.
That makes the problem all the simpler. We'll send the kid down there.
Wait a minute now. It seems I hear somewheres that babies bring good luck.
Yes, sir. How long we could stand a little good luck around here?
Pay dirt's getting thinner than grass.
Yeah, and besides, what'll the folks down at Red Banks be thinking if we can't take care of our own kid?
Who's gonna be the baby's mother, Kentuck? You?
No, but I reckon Katie could, being as how she's already a mother.
Katie?
Yes, ma'am. She's our best harness mare, and right prime for the job.
I'm not going to waste any more time arguing. You're going down to Red Banks and find a home for that baby right now.
Mr. Oakhurst.
That's final. Well, boys, who's playing?
I am, Oakhurst, and for all you got.
Give me $10,000 worth of chips.
Where'd you get it?
5 miles of Roaring Creek. The partner's filing now.
5 miles of Roaring Creek.
Coley's $1,000 a chip.
Put them all on the black.
Spin them!
Kentuck.
Yeah, Mr. Oakhurst.
The baby stays here.
That's fine, great.
Go and feed Katie some oats if you can find some, and treat her with reverence.
Yes, sir. Hey, Mr. Oakhurst, we gotta find a name for that kid.
It's Red Brother, you lose.
We've got a name.
Not that I can recollect, sir.
Luck, you fool, luck. Yes, luck, a little.
Well, how about giving me some action?
Action you'll get, young lady.
Openers? Opened.
Stay.
How many?
Three.
One for me. Check.
You know that five cars of the same suit figures pretty high, don't you?
Sure, got 'em.
That information will just cost you another stack of whites.
Seen and raise.
Bluffing?
Put in another stack and see.
Now you're gonna learn something. Care for that?
Not much. Care for this?
You win.
I've something to say to you. You'll be interested too, John.
Homer, watch my table.
All right, Luck. Come on, boys.
And I say it's high time she learned something besides cards.
Make her dry up, will you, Oakhurst?
We could send her to Miss Thatcher's school in Frisco. We certainly can afford it now.
Off fiddlesticks.
As far as that goes, we'll soon have a school in Poker Flat. And a church if the mines keep booming. And all due to luck here.
You mean to tell me you're actually superstitious about this kid?
Superstitious? I'm absolutely convinced the stork that brought her lays golden eggs. As far as Luck's future is concerned, my plans are already made. In a year, I'll have all I want of this country. My best won't be good enough for her. I'm going to take her back east with me.
Your plans sound rather exclusive. We're partners, aren't we?
If that means sharing what comes in, we are.
I'm not talking about money.
I know you're not.
If you two are going to fight again, I'm going to work. Somebody's got to tend to business around here.
Remember all this talk about bringing religion and education to Poker Flat? Well, sir, folks, the stage just in front of both of you.
Well, it's not every day we get a chance to look at a couple of museum pieces, like a minister and a school teacher. You ladies join me.
Mrs. Tremaine, Mrs. Parker, and Mr. Eldridge.
As I was saying, Reverend, the gold which I purvey doesn't come out of the ground. It's the golden California sunshine, sir. 350 days every year.
Now, that's very interesting.
Thinking of going to school, Oakhurst?
It's an idea, Duchess.
Well, folks, now that you've met and welcomed our new school teacher and our minister,
well,
I hope...
As a matter of fact, I don't believe we have met everybody.
you see...
They won't be church members, Pop.
I'm Sam Woods.
I'm John Oakhurst. And this is Luck.
Well, I'm glad to know you, Luck. And we'll have to see a lot of each other.
Anytime you feel lucky, you'll find me at the second table.
I'd like you to meet my friend, Miss Helen Colby, Mr. Oakhurst, and...
Delighted, Miss Colby. You arrived right at the height of the social season. You think you'll like it?
I intend to.
Well, I'll see to it that you meet all the best people. Myself, of course, and Miss Colby, the Duchess, Duchess, the Bishop.
How do you do?
It's a pleasure. I hope you're going to be my first pupil, Luck.
Not me. I'm getting along right comfortable without schooling.
Oh, but there's so many things to learn. I'm sure your father would want you.
Shucks, he ain't nobody's father.
Her folks are dead, Miss Colby. I'm her guardian.
Oh. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing you all at my first services on Sunday.
I'm afraid we can't make it.
You see, Bishop, Sunday's our busy day.
What she means to say is that you're sort of a competitor. Just where do you intend to hold church?
Well, I really don't know. Mr. Bedford, where is it to be?
Well, sir, you see, our building fund is still a little shy. Some of us haven't prospered quite as much as Oakhurst has with his gaming hall.
Yes, we figured on holding our meetings in the open.
Suppose it rains.
Well, now, that'd be unusual, Miss Colbert.
I could donate the use of my place, temporarily at least.
Are you out of your mind?
That's very generous of you, Mr. Oakhurst.
We don't want it.
Why not?
Well, because it's not orthodox. Holding meeting in a place like Oakhurst.
Do you think it would be large enough?
Biggest in town.
Then I accept. Gladly. Thank you.
It's very kind of Mr. Oakhurst, but really...
Helen, it's sinners I'm after. And I can't think of a better place to find them.
That's right.
Next Sunday morning, then?
I'll have it ready for you.
Fine.
Good day. Come on, Luck. Coming?
I suppose she's already saying Mr. Oakhurst is one of nature's noblemen.
Shh, don't ruin the illusion.
I can't seem to follow your play, Oakhurst.
He can't either, because the play he's running isn't in the cards.
We have come into a new land, with its new problems and new opportunities. We have the courage to know its people and to see them for what they are, not for what they appear to be. We pray that they will likewise try to know us, that they will try to understand our mission here, and that thy humble servant may accomplish his works through their trust and their friendship.
Hey, Oakhurst, when's you going to camp meeting business?
Just sit down and make yourself comfortable, Sonoma. We'll soon be open for regular business. You'll pardon the interruption, Parson. Boys will be boys.
It's us you ought to be apologizing to. We rode 60 miles to get here, so we could drink and gamble and have some fun. I didn't get saddle warts to listen to no sermon.
Silence! Silence! It may seem rather peculiar to most of you to see me lined up on the righteous side. I'm not exactly known as a religious man.
That you ain't.
If But I'm sure you'll all agree I'm a practical man.
Granted.
Now, there is a way you can stop the parson from holding services here every Sunday morning.
How's that? All right.
Yeah, how?
Build him a church.
And I'll tell you a better way. Chase that sky pilot back to his own diggings. Now
you're talking. Shuffle him.
What's that got to do with...
You said you wanted to gamble, didn't you?
Yeah, but...
That says the house can beat you. One cut of the cards.
It's a lot of rocks, Oakhurst.
Put up or shut up.
Well, I didn't say that I was...
Go ahead, cut him. The ten of diamonds. All right, look. The queen of spades. Thank you, Sonoma. Ladies and gentlemen, Sonoma has set a fine example for you as the first contributor to the Oakhurst Fund for a Church in Poker Flat. I want you all to give, and the more you give, the sooner the pastor will have his church, and the sooner you'll have this place back for your regular Sunday entertainment. Now, luck will pass the hat. And I warn you, if you don't give freely, she'll put a blight on your fortunes. All right, luck. Go get it.
Go wider. There you are, gents. Lady Luck smiling at you. Looks like a prosperous year.
Maybe a little girl like to drink, huh? Go on, luck. Good. Good. Big drink. Good luck. Okay.
All right, Luck, you go to your room.
I won't.
The kid stays right here, Oakus.
You go to your room.
Better mind him, Luck.
I won't. Cherokee Jim and me will have a lot of fun. Let me go.
Go on. All right, Jim. You go out of this place for keeps.
Wait a minute, Oakus. I don't know what's come over you lately. Something has, and having a right to my private opinion, I'm saying I don't like it. I rode all the way up here from Calaveras to entertain myself.
I judge it was a pretty fast ride. The gold sack you put in the collection had the Calaveras Mill stamp on it.
That's neither here nor there in this man's town. And that's nothing to the fast ride you give me with the cards. But I'm not bellyaching about that. For when you go so far as to order a part of mine out of your place, I'm voting against you.
Gentlemen, I guess it's my deal.
Measly little pop gun.
Not so measly at close range. Go ahead, get him out of here.
Take him out, Hagrid.
Get out of here.
Looks like the drinks are on me, Oakhurst.
Put that away, Charlie. What are you going to have?
Straight. Just as man to man, do you consider that square poker pulling a dandy out of your sleeve?
Just as plunderer to pillager, I think you're using darn poor taste criticizing my methods.
Maybe you're right. You most generally are.
Sonoma? Were you ever a father?
Yeah, I think so. As I recall...
Well, I'm one by proxy. And it's going to give me a very unpleasant duty to perform.
Come here, young lady. You behave yourself.
I won't go to no school.
You won't, huh? We'll see about that.
Let me go!
I'm going to warm you if you don't behave yourself. Come on now.
Why, hello, Luck. I'm glad to see you again.
Guess what the Duchess says is right. You sure got your hooks in him.
I hope you'll forgive this child's manners. It just bears out some of the things you said. You still want her?
Why, of course I do. Come on, Luck. Come on, Luck, come on. Someday you're going to tell Mr. Oakhurst you're glad he brought you here.
I won't even be speaking to him.
She's up to you now. She's still very young in years. Maybe it's not too late to teach her to be like other children.
What's he talking about? All the kids in town wish they was like me.
Of course, Luck. There's still so many things to be done, and Mr. Oakhurst is too busy to take care of them.
Well, I won't stay. I won't stand for school, and you can't make me. Oakhurst, please, you're bluffing, and you know it. Oakhurst, please, you're gonna take me back. Oakhurst, please. Please, Oakhurst.
Now am I bluffing?
No. I guess you ain't.
It's 2 weeks ago today, wasn't it? I hope Lux reading, writing, arithmetic is doing better than we are with this place here. Business is terrible.
You mean you don't know how Luck's coming on?
How should I?
And you haven't seen the teacher?
No.
I thought when you took the kid over there, you'd kind of be wanting to reserve yourself a regular place on her sofa. I'm sorry, I had you all wrong.
No, Duchess, you had me right. But I'm inclined to think I'm a lot better off right here in a hard chair. At least I won't make any plays here that I can't back.
I told you that bluff you started wasn't in the cards.
Yes, you told me. Now, would it be too much if I asked you to mind your own business?
I am. You're my business.
You're bluffing too, Duchess. Nothing of the kind.
I thought maybe you kind of missed me.
You belong here, and here you stay.
Then I reckon it was her you come to see.
You better run along and play.
If I have to grow up to be a schoolmarm to make you like me, I guess you'll never like me.
I told you to run along.
I reckon I can take a hint. Come on, kid.
Are there any hearts not broken because of you, Mr. Oakhurst?
A few of the colder ones.
It's nice to see you again, Mr. Oakhurst.
Thank you, sir.
Well, the plans for the church are coming along just fine, thanks to your support.
I'm glad to help you drum up your business, as long as you don't interfere with mine.
Well, Helen, I'll be running along now.
If you must.
Good day.
Good day to you, sir. She'll need books and clothes, and perhaps this will take care of it.
Oh, that's far too much.
And buy a few knickknacks for the school.
John Oakhurst, like most other people in Poker Flats, you've wasted a lot of things in your life. Mainly yourself. But you're not wasting when you make this kind of investment.
If you're going to start delving into the moral economics of Poker Flat, I'm afraid you're being extravagant with our time.
Oh, but it's an extravagant subject. You see, when you talk about the people in Poker Flat, you're talking about the hundreds of those in other camps and the thousands that'll be here someday. It's all very simple, Mr. Oakhurst. Turn those resources in the right direction, and you've got an empire.
Presto, just like that?
Not quite, unfortunately. But you and others like you are going to build it.
Me?
You.
You wouldn't be too sure about that, would you?
Sure as shooting.
You've got all the earmarks of an idealist and a very strong-willed young woman.
Weak-willed young women wouldn't come out here, Mr. Oakhurst.
Very interesting.
Miss Colby, come on, I want you.
I enjoyed our little talk very much, Miss Colby. I do hope you'll be able to do something about your charge's manners.
Good day.
Goodbye.
What did you want with me, Luck?
I forget. Was something.
Uh-huh. What are you doing with those cards?
Let me have them, Miss Colby. They're all that's keeping me from getting downright homesick.
You won't have any use for them now. We don't teach card playing in school.
But you ought to. The sharps will be trimming those kids of yours right and left when they grow up.
Come on, dear.
Why, you ornery little scavenger.
My friend, Tor. It's the only brotherly gesture the deceased ever made.
Who accommodated him?
Kentuck.
When I'm away from this place, you're in charge. Is that your idea of good advertising?
Well, Don Juan, what do you expect me to do? Keeping the peace in this establishment is your job, not mine.
I know the answer. And if you men had an ounce of gumption, you'd drive him and all of his kind out of the town.
Well, that's one way to handle it.
Well, as a matter of fact, that's the only way. Drive them all out. The gamblers and the murderers, the thieves, the drunkards and the dance hall girls. Oakhurst Place is the headquarters for these offenders. Get rid of him and all the others like him, and then this town will be a fit place for your wives and families to live in.
You're right. Time we took some action.
Let's string him up.
Here, gentlemen.
Fighting murder with murder, that won't give you any satisfaction. Even if you achieve your results. Now, you're trying to build a church. And I don't think you want a hanging tree alongside of it.
Our problem is to establish a definite law enforcement agency.
I saw the vigilantes work in Sacramento and Frisco, and it wasn't a pretty sight. I agree with the Reverend. We don't want any hanging parties here.
It seems to me, while we're hiring a parson, we ought to get one with a snort of ginger to him.
That's spoken like a true horse trader, Brother Wilkes.
Well, I never expect to get much out of a horse that I buy sight unseen.
You know, I have an idea that you probably get a lot more out of the horse than the horse gets out of you. And judging from your church offerings, the hay contribution must be practically invisible. Now you sit down.
What do you mean?
Go on, sit down there. Now, this is just a suggestion, but I think you ought to appoint a committee to go and have a talk with Oakhurst. Let him know that even in the absence of official law agencies, his business must be run more orderly. And warn him what you're prepared to do.
Now, that sounds fair enough. Now, if it's all right with you, ladies and gentlemen, we'll appoint the Reverend here a committee of one.
Now, you see, when a layman sticks his nose into somebody else's business, he's merely giving advice, but when a minister does, well, it's the popular supposition that he's meddling.
You've started something, Parson. You got to go through with it.
Yes, you do. Well, I'll do what I can.
And please help Oakhurst to keep on having a lot of good luck, because he's usually a square shooter, even if he ain't been very square with me. Make him like me as much as he likes somebody else I know. And make him want me back. 'Cause he's a fool to think he don't need me. Bless him, Lord. Even if he is a fool. And bless Miss Colby. Amen.
Mr. Oakhurst's ears must be burning.
Huh? I reckon you do some right smart praying for him yourself.
In a little different way, love. The Lord helps those who help themselves. We pray, of course, but most of it's up to John Oakhurst.
The Lord helps those who help themselves.
Stop wrinkling your forehead. I'm going to come in here again before I go to bed. And young lady, if you're not asleep, you're going to study twice as hard tomorrow.
I'm plumb asleep already.
Good night, dear.
Good night.
Thank you.
The Lord helps them that help themselves.
Jim.
Yeah, so am I. Reckon I'm gonna kind of miss him.
Kind of stupid of him shooting up my bar.
I guess he's learned his lesson.
No hard feelings?
Laws, he no. Wouldn't be admiring you much if you let a fella like Jim tromp on your toes.
It takes an omen me, for instance. Good friends as we are. If he tromped on my tootsies, I'd let him have it.
And vice versa. How about a little game?
I'm glad you got some, and I didn't.
Give us credit for that.
Where?
Yes, sir. We'll take 100 apiece.
Now, like I was saying, not that Sonoma and me ain't pards, but having the same ideals, as the saying goes, we gotta stick together.
That's why we come to see you. Considering this vigilante stir-up, we all gotta stick together.
Gentlemen, your ideals are my ideals.
Shake on it.
I'm sorry to bother you, Mr. Oakhurst, but there's a little matter that I'd like to...
Just for your information, Parson, the hospitality around here ain't what it used to be.
You'll find Deacon Oakhurst has backslid considerable. Don't belong to your flock no more.
What's on your mind?
Well, it's a personal matter. I'd like to speak to you alone about it.
I trust the subject is an unpleasant one.
You may find it so.
In that case, I hope your dignity doesn't bruise too easily.
Sit in, Dutchess. Take his hand.
Here, let me help you,
Dutchess. Yeah, let me help you.
Here, we'll
sit
right down.
Thank you, boys.
Come. What's biting the Reverend?
Vigilantitis.
You and your downy flock are making me the goat for a lot of things that I can't control. I didn't invent these disorders. They've been happening for centuries. And if they weren't happening, you'd be out of a job. You people can't cure them by taking a shortcut to me.
We'll cure them in time. With definite law enforcement. Sheriffs and deputies duly authorized. But Oakhurst, I'm asking myself, where will you be by that time?
I've been asking myself the same question off and on for a good many years.
I think you realize that I didn't relish this mission.
Yes, I suppose maybe you're trying to help me. But you're wasting your time. You go back and tell those trained sheep of yours they can go right on bleeding. Tell them that I stand shoulder to shoulder against them with my own crowd. And tell them not to stick their nose through my fence because goats have horns.
Unlucky at love, lucky at cards.
Women run from me like I had rattlers. Cards ought to be my meat. But I ain't never been foundered yet on good fortune.
Throw the other one away. Don't hold a kicker.
Luck.
Luck, sure enough. Kid, you're gonna play out this game, honey.
Oakhurst will give you a whaling if he finds you here.
I figure it's worth it. Give me three.
Keep kicking!
All that.
Yeah, yeah. I want to kick higher.
Vincent!
Peach!
Things are picking up around here.
Doc, you ought to be home in bed, Miss Colby.
I'm sure this lady and these gentlemen will agree that that's where you belong, Doc.
Sit in, miss. We'll make it whist if you like.
Don't wait around for me, Miss Colby. This ain't no proper place for you.
For neither of us, Luck.
Begging your pardon, ma'am, this ain't no Little Red Schoolhouse. She's winning for me and she stays.
Take her out of this place.
Parson, when you get slapped on one cheek, don't the Bible tell you to turn the other?
Yes, but further than that, the Bible gives me no instructions.
Nice, quiet fellow, that parson.
Yeah, quiet like a stick of dynamite.
Put your hand in your pocket. All of you.
Of all the prize turntails, you win the yellow ribbon, Oakhurst. And I'm going to have the pleasure of pinning it on you one of these days.
Is that a promise?
I got a lot of bad habits. But more often than not, I keep my word.
You're hurt.
It's just a scratch compared to the hurt some people's feelings are going to get. Miss Colby, you've done some high and mighty talking around here, but the first little job you took over seems to be too much for you.
It's my fault, Oakhurst. Honest it is. She can't help it because I sneaked out tonight.
I think you can take Luck's word for it.
I've heard about enough out of you, too. All this chatter about disturbing influences. Before you burn your fingers on that old chestnut again, let me do a little preaching. Now, go ahead, finish your job if you're able.
I suppose I have failed so far, but...
And I'll tell you why. Because your silly imagination is 10 times bigger than you are. You're just a little voice crying in a great big wilderness. You've got half the sense you claim, you'll go back where you came from. And take Luck with you.
I've got enough sense to know you're not worth trying to help. You or any of the others. I'm sick of you and of myself for ever having come here. You've got some poker face, John.
Quiet. You don't want to destroy the illusion, do you? All right, go on back to your games. Music!
Turning in, Mr. Oakhurst?
Stumpy, you skedaddle over to the mining office and get their doctor right away.
Sure.
Shucks, I figured he was only creased.
More than that, Kentuck. And the worst of it all is he doesn't care whether it's for love or money. It's always that way when you start a bluff, you can't finish. Come on, get it.
Helen, I don't mind the licking I'm getting. It's my business to keep on taking it, but... You... Well, I'm taking you out of this place tomorrow just as fast as that stage will carry us. The three of us. You and Luck and me, we'll go to some place where at least we can have a decent life together.
Are you proposing to us, Parson?
Yes, Luck, I am.
Well, it's no go. Miss Colby, you can't see past your nose. If you didn't catch which way the wind was blowing when Oka said those mean things to you. Me? Ever since I was knee-high, I could call a turn on every play Oka's was making.
Out of the mouths of babes.
He acted nasty as I'll get out tonight. But I knew it was the same old game. Only now it's both of us he's trying to get rid of. Because he's got a crazy notion that even this town ain't fit for us.
Oh, then it's a compliment when Oakhurst wants to get rid of someone.
Can't say about that, Miss Colby. Gosh, he's in love with us. Don't you see? And he ain't gonna get rid of us.
No luck, he ain't.
Helen. I want you to hear something now from Sam Woods. Not the Reverend Sam Woods. Helen, I'd rather see John Oakhurst dead than to see you throw yourself away on him. Good night.
Well, Helen, Parson. You better say your prayers for Oakhurst. Sonoma shot a little straighter than we figured. Come on, Doc, let's hurry.
Of course, he'll require constant attention.
I'll see to it, Doctor. I'll help you. Doctor, you'll stop in as often as possible.
As often as necessary. Frankly, I'm afraid the outcome of this depends about as much with the Reverend's department as it does with mine. Good day.
Good day, Doctor.
Whatever the doctor means you are to do, Parson, you better do it quick.
I'm not speaking now as the minister of your gospel, but rather as one of your weaker sons, who has known what it is to feel malice and envy toward a fellow man. As such, I stand before you, knowing that in your great wisdom, the prayers of the weak are answered as mercifully as the prayers of the righteous and the strong. In all humble penitence, I plead that you spare the life of my friend, John Oakhurst.
Westward, the course of empire takes its way. Big, brave dreams out of soft heads.
John.
John Oakhurst. Used to be a fool for luck.
Fool to think you could send me away.
That's right. Best card he ever drew. Traded it for the deuce of clubs. Stupid of him.
John Oakhurst. That's the first time I've ever heard you talk since.
Oh, you're doing fine. The whole town's talking about it. Your place has been so respectable lately that they're thinking of holding the next taffy pull there. Stop scowling. You'll frighten the horse.
The horse and I understand each other perfectly. You use a bridle on him and you're trying to use a halter on me. I don't know what the world's coming to. Last year, a radical in England wrote a pamphlet about letting women vote. He's in jail, of course.
Any woman that's worth the snap of your fingers does vote nowadays, always has. Naturally not at the polls, but she picks out a man with possibilities. And if she's clever, why, she gives him a push the way he ought to go. And if he does amount to something, she lets him think he did it.
Of all the female Napoleons.
Well, now there's a pretty sight.
Doing a little civic advertising? Warning. If you are law-abiding, welcome to Poker Flat. If not, keep going. We are prepared to deal quickly with all violators in this town. Citizens Committee.
Considering the recent developments, I don't suppose Mr. Oakhurst needs to be much concerned about that.
No, I reckon not. I've heard it whispered that you even talked to closing up that shop of yours. How about it, Mr. Oakhurst?
Whispers are sometimes just whispers, Mr. Bedford.
Well, all I know is what Zeph Baldwin's wife told my wife that Miss Colby told her.
If you'll pardon us, I must be getting back.
Chuck, where's Oakhurst?
Uncle Billy, what are you doing with that yellow ribbon?
It's for Oakhurst. Where is he?
Pretty little thing, ain't it?
He told me to give you this.
Who told you?
I met Sonoma in High Grade on the Sawtooth Road, and Sonoma says, give this to Oakhurst. It's the color of you.
Is that all he said?
Well, let me think.
Come on. What did he say?
Oh. He said if you cared to ride out to the Boulders about 7 seasons,
alone. He'd be mighty proud to pin that yellow ribbon on you. Of course, I told him you'd be there.
Have a drink, Charlie.
Get a saddle horse ready for Mr. Oakhurst right away, Dave.
Sonoma must be a weary in the light.
Sure, hankering for the pearly gates.
Too bad we can't all go out.
Yeah, because we ain't had a good shooting match here since the church took over.
Kentuck, you take this to the Citizens Committee. If Sonoma wants trouble, they'll see that he gets it.
If that's an order, you better get someone else to fill it.
Better speak your native tongue, John. We don't understand lots you say these days.
Kentuck will understand all right. You work here, don't you?
I guess maybe I don't.
Come on now, cool off. You might as well face it. This law and order business is here to stay. I knew it had to come. I knew it a long time ago. We'll build up a good, prosperous town here. We'll all be better off. More money, better conditions.
A trained parrot couldn't say it much better.
Kentuck, get back there. Set up the drinks for the boys. Give them all they want.
I reckon they've got all they want of you, Mr. Oakhurst.
What are you doing? Think I've been juggling the accounts?
No, I'm just going to buy you out, that's all.
Well, I'm not selling.
You sold out quite a while ago, John. This little transaction's only a matter of form. I can only say I feel sorry for you.
Sure you don't feel a little sorry for yourself?
I've got brains, John. Enough to know what I really am. Why, I couldn't go back to what I was 15 years ago, any more than you can. Whatever we are is in our blood. It brought you to where you are, didn't it? And you had a lot more to lose than you've got now.
A lot more to keep, you mean? And this time, I'm going to keep it.
Then I pity her, too. She's Wood's kind. You're my kind. And wherever you end up with her, there'll be roulette whirling in your head and cards tugging at your fingers.
Does that mean I have to go out and kill a man or get killed?
No. That's one of the smaller items. But I guess she can love you, even if you have turned yellow, clear down to your heels. I do.
Thank you.
But the question is, how much will you love her for making you that way? Well, everything's hunky-dory now, all right. But someday you'll hate her for making you hate yourself. And she'll hate you because you don't like the cage you live in. It's a bad bargain any way you look at it, John. Sonoma would have done you both a big favor if he'd have drilled you clean out of it that night. Oh, I'm sorry. Come right in, dearie. He needs a lot of something, and I think you're it. John, I just saw Kentuck. I'm sure you know how I feel about such things, but I wanted to tell you, you're facing it squarely and sensibly.
I think I am.
You're not going through with it, Kentuck told me.
That old relic couldn't tell you his right name.
Well, I'll tell you what your name will be as far as I'm concerned. It'll be Mud, John Oakhurst.
Well, if my aim's bad.
You can't do this. Listen to me. Listen, John. Even if you get through it safely, I'll never see you again. It'll kill everything that we talked about. It'll mean that...
The collapse of an empire? You'd better stick to your storybooks and quit fooling around with realities.
You know what I'd do? I'd go straightway to the vigilantes. Maybe they can stop it.
Do you mean that?
Sure. I figured on doing the same thing myself, if he showed spunk enough to go.
Thanks.
Keep your eye on those horses. Don't let them wander free. I don't think Oakhurst is quite yellow enough to set the citizens on us. I've seen some considerable changes around here lately.
Those horses are the least you got to fret about, Sonoma. Now, if I was meeting up with a targeteer like Oakhurst, I believe I'd want me a sharpshooter up in the belfry somewhere.
Well, I don't. You understand?
Being you're a part of mine, I just thought I'd mention it. You're too hair-trigger to meet up with a cool hombre like Oakhurst. He just lets him whiz by and draws a bead.
That you, Oakhurst?
Yeah, Sonoma?
Yeah. Remember, any pot shooting from you, and I'll take it to your trap and direct on my toes. I'm walking, Oakhurst.
I'm walking. Sorry, Sonoma. I won't need this, Sonoma.
Nope. Reckon I won't neither. It belongs to you, pot shooter.
Barton.
I suppose one of you has a court summons.
Take that gun. Where's that rope?
Here it is. There's a limb.
You're the judge, Parson?
Well, I'm going to judge this case.
I don't like to see you put yourself out.
No inconvenience at all. Men, I'm ready to agree that some of the strong measures you advocated have their values. I've learned that you can't fight violence with trust or reasoning.
Come on, let's say him off.
Now, what I'm offering now is a compromise. I know now, Mr. Bedford, that you were right when you said that Oakhurst and the others like him would have to go.
I still say it.
That's too tame.
Oh, come on, wait. Oh, the ropes.
Listen
the
to the parson.
You once suggested a way to deal with them. Drive them out wholesale. Clean up this town.
Look, I was just wondering, did Miss Colby have anything in particular to say about this?
No.
She's in school this morning?
No. It's Saturday.
That's right. I was just wondering. I suppose you wish you were going with me, huh?
Yeah. I mean, no. I mean, I reckon the parson thinks I'd be better off here. With him. Guess maybe he's right.
I guess maybe he is.
Believe me, Oakhurst, I'm not finding any personal triumph in this.
Of course, you'll accept my congratulations. Pass them on to Helen.
I will. You'll probably agree someday that she more than anybody else benefited by this.
Come on, vamoose, Oakhurst.
Well, folks, you got a long trip ahead. Start moving.
Oh, guys! Oh, God, take me with you.
Well, boss, most of us have elected to take the South Trail. You better join us.
Oh, thanks. I'm heading over the ridge. I hear they've made a new strike at Sandy Bar. It seemed like old times.
It's a hard ride where you're going. Mighty wintery up there this time of the year. You better change your mind. Come along with us.
Thanks, Charlie. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Mr. Oakhurst. Goodbye, Duchess.
Good luck.
Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Kentuck. Everybody going to Angel's Camp, follow me.
Goodbye, Duchess.
You sticking with me, Kentuck?
You're crazy if you think I ain't.
Me too, Mr. Oakhurst.
I'm afraid your loyalty's a rather dubious tribute, Uncle Billy.
Oh, sure.
All right, come on.
Did you have to ride this direction?
Did you?
What are you doing here?
Waiting for you.
That's fine. I'm afraid you'll have to keep right on waiting.
You'll have a long ride back, sister.
May strike you funny, but I'm not going back.
No, it don't strike me funny.
I'm here to tell this is a free country.
Ellen, I can't stop you from riding this trail, but I'm warning you, it means a return trip for you.
You don't know even how to follow rules, John. How do you think you can make them? You drift and you blunder, and now and then you manage to do the right thing. When you do, you're worth all the trouble it takes. Yes, sir? I think we'll do all right.
Yes, sir. I think she'll do all right.
Hmm?
There ain't nobody home but a few spiders, and I reckon if we chase them out, the ladies could sleep in there.
Won't that be sweet?
Yes, like the three bears. I suppose the big cross bear will sleep in a cave.
And the bumptious little bear is going right back home tomorrow as fast as Kentuck can carry her.
Mr. Oakhurst, you're a chronic wag.
I've been a lot of weak plays in my life, Miss Colby. This is one I'm going to carry through. Ladies, you'll find the drawing room right down the corridor on the left.
You first, my dear. We're the soul of hospitality, even to those who just drop in.
Since you're being so all-fired formal, you better go first. Your age entitles you to it, my dear.
Billy!
No, confound it.
That's not the half of it. Billy's gone.
The thieving reptile.
Shh. So are the provisions, Mr. Oakhurst.
And the horses.
I thank heaven the wolves that only eat him. It'll be a general good riddance. They die straight off of dyspepsy.
Where do you think you're going?
To cut out his gizzard. Darn his eyes.
No, you're not. You can't outrun horses.
Nutty.
You might make it back to Poker Flat and get us some more livestock and gear.
You all mean start right now?
If you don't, we might all be snowed in.
The way this snow is piling in, I mightn't get back through to you. Why don't you take a little walk?
Because for a fellow who's always tried to do his walking alone, I seem to have acquired a couple of shining responsibilities.
I reckon there's a lot of Turks in your same fix, Mr. Oakhurst. Goodbye. And if I don't...
Forget all about the ifs, Kentuck. And get back here with some horses and provisions, quick.
No hard feelings about anything I ever said to you.
No. No hard feelings about that push I gave you.
Shucks, no. I was always right proud to have you push me, Mr. Oakhurst.
All right, go ahead.
Still partners?
You bet we are. And always will be.
You mean that?
You couldn't get me to sell out.
Same old poker face. You just keep on bluffing, will you? I kind of like it.
Just keep your eyes open. Don't let down for a second. If you fall asleep like the Duchess, it's a long shot against you.
But if they come before too long, there's still a chance for her, isn't there?
Certainly. And Tuck will see that we get Doug out of here, all right. Probably be here any minute. Eyes wide open now. Promise? Helen!
John, you spoiled a perfectly nice dream.
It's not the first one I spoiled.
It's funny. I'd rather have you spoil them than someone else make them come true. The important thing is we're going to go on trying, aren't we?
Trying? I'm afraid I forgot the meaning of that word some time ago.
Believe me, John, all the empire I ever really wanted was just a little corner somewhere for us.
You'll find that little corner somewhere. Some nice chap like Sam Woods, for instance. That'd be luck for both of you. And it's in the cards.
I know one way to keep you from trading an ace like Sam Woods for a deuce like John Oakhurst.
You can't get rid of me. You found that out. I know you don't want to.
Helen. Helen. Helen.
Get those shovels out, boys. We'll have to work fast.
All right, give me one quick here.
Looks like somebody moved out. I think I'll investigate.
Good talk.
Helen.
She's dead.
Helen. Helen. Helen.
Here.
Drink this, Helen.
John.
He's gone.
Gone.
Yes. I always knew that sometime I'd be coming to take you home.
We must get her on her feet. And keep her moving.
We've got to start her circulation. Go ahead, we'll take care of her. All right, get in there. Now, here, turn around. Now, whoa. Sit down here for a moment.
We've got to stick together now, Luck. Helen will need us more than ever.
Yes, but we can't ever like her as much as we did Oakhurst.
Well, maybe.
No. I guess it don't pay to get stuck on a feller too much. They just up and leave you holding the sack.
No, Luck, I don't think he wanted to leave anybody holding the sack. He simply went whichever way the cards fell. He didn't have to trust in the turn of cards. He was strong. The strongest, and yet the weakest of all of them.